And I want to encourage you that if you don't already have a life journey team active in your life, and I'm going to define in a few minutes what I mean by a life journey team, active in your life, that I will inspire and motivate you enough that you will put that into place from this moment forward. When we get that spiritual part of our life right, everything else starts to fall in place with grace and ease and solidity. Is that a word? Anyway, oh, I just made it up too. This is my day for making stuff up. So I want to share with you the why of a life journey team, the what of a life journey team, and the how of a life journey team. So the why of it. We are all spiritual seedlings compared to our potential. Would you not agree? We are all spiritual seedlings compared to our potential. You know, you absolutely know that no matter what you've already accomplished spiritually in your life, there is that much more for you. Am I right? You know that about yourself. I know that about myself, that we are spiritual seedlings compared to what we have the capacity to become. And when you think of a seedling, for a seedling to flourish, it needs nutrition, it needs support, it needs an environment that's going to help it to become strong, to take root, to be solid, and to then spring forth and to grow. While it's true that the spiritual journey is a solo one, it is also true that we don't need to make it alone. We've got to do the work individually, but we don't have to go about it alone. I think Martin Luther King Jr. was absolutely right when he talked about the idea of the beloved community as a vision of the way that we should be together as a human family, not a human race. We need to drop that word race. It's not a competition. It's a human family. And part of what gives us the strength and the stamina and the deep abiding faith to hold the vision and work collectively toward a world that works for everyone, a beloved community, is making sure that we are solid in ourselves, making sure that we understand and feel spiritually supported. That has got to be the foundation on which everything else in our life is built. Jesus told us, and this is the second point, our spiritual growth and unfoldment is vital to our quality of life. Your spiritual growth, not your mental advancement, not your success, not your goals. Your spiritual growth is vital to the success and well-being of your life, period. Jesus said, seek God first and everything will be added unto you. And he wasn't talking about a closet full of stuff. He was talking about a purposeful life. He was talking about being awake. He was talking about being a beneficial presence. When we seek God first, which doesn't mean a God in the sky that is keeping score and demanding that we worship, that's not God. That's a projection of humanity. When we seek God first, it is to seek the Spirit, to seek the divine in ourselves and in each other. And when we seek that first, everything else that we need for a life to be full and meaningful and purposeful and joyful will come as a result. Another point with regard to the why of it has to do with the fact that there is absolutely, without question, added power when we come together spiritually. How many of you who meditate at home do feel something different when we meditate together in group here in this room? Raise your hand.
Thanks for listening. The Unity Center, transforming lives and healing our world. Check us out Sundays at 9 and 11. Subscribe to our podcasts and download our free app for instant access to a wealth of spiritual teachings, services, and events.